And I know God is with you. That is why you are here. I know God is with you. I know God is with your nation. I say, I know. If God is not with you, you will not come here. Tell your neighbor, God is with me. That is why I'm here today. Thank you, Lord. Be with us at home, all over the world, wherever you are. I know God is with you. I know. That is why you pay attention. You are under the influence of this telecast. I salute your faith. Once again, east, south, north, west, I salute your faith. Hallelujah. Yes, you have on your table the message. And today you will not make jest of me. I will prove you wrong. I will not mention time. I want to prove you wrong. I will not mention time. Yes, I will not mention time. But I will say God's time is the best. I know you have been waiting, looking at the time. This is why we remove anything time here. So when you are looking, you just look at here. But at your back, you can see time, but not here. God's time is the best. At God's time, everything you are looking for, right on your table. Hallelujah. I said I will not talk of time, and I will not talk of time. We are interested in your life changing. When I say we, people of God, partner all over the world, faith people, they are interested in your life changing. Hallelujah. Life changing transformation. That is our interest. Sometimes people will ask, why TB Joshua? We have never seen you ask your member, raise your offering, your tithe, your this, your that. They keep asking me. I say, well, it is scriptural. It is right. It is written. But I'm afraid. You know, some Saturdays say, this is fruit for you. I'm afraid. But it's for me, I'm afraid. Just, I'm afraid. What is the meaning you are afraid? It is written. It is scriptural. It is right. Offering, contribution, whatever you call it. Wow. It's blessing. You are blessed to bless others. You bless your ministry. But as for me, I'm always, if it's not come from your heart, I'm always afraid to take it. If it's not from your heart, I'm always afraid to receive. Because it will not work good for me. It will not work good for me. I will have them, but it will not work good for me. If that is not from your heart, and you give me, I'm taking trouble. Right from little, I know that. That if what you are giving me is not from your heart and I receive it, it's like I'm receiving trouble. Not blessing. That is for me. I'm not talking of any other. For me, you know, we men of God, we have different habits. That is a habit. That is my habit. That if you give me something that is not from your heart, I may have it plenty, but trouble, plenty. So, I say, if I continue collecting, offering, contribution of any kind, from the sick, at least the very sick here, you may look good in appearance, but inside you are. You know, sickness is not my appearance. This is why you see beautiful people, look good people. You suddenly learn that he or she sleep and die just like that. There's no way you could know people that are sick because they look good, fat, okay, appearance does not say it's not safe. That does not determine whatever you call it. So if I continue collecting, let's say offering this, that, from the sick, from those who are in bondage, without being used by God to set them free, it's like one is collecting rot cost. Life is all about give and take. Before you can give something from your heart, you must have received something from that person from his heart. For somebody to say, from my heart I gave you, it means you must have received something somewhere from that person's heart. Are you with me? For somebody to say, oh, I'm giving you, it's from my heart, I'm happy, it means, wow, it's a blessing. That is what you call blessing. There are do good of God and there are do good of man. Different. When you see people doing good, this good we are doing, there are two ways of doing it, of God, of man. How will you know of God, of man? That is why we have charity organizations over the world. The rich, you see them giving $1 billion, £1 billion to the orphanage home to raise the standard of living, but many of them are not do of man, of God, they do of man. So there are do good of God and do good of man. When you do good of God, it will set people free. It will set the sick, the captive, the bondage. Those who are in bondage will be set free. Those who are sick will be healed. This is what Jesus said, what God said. I mean, our Lord Jesus Christ said, he went about doing good. Heal the sick. Set the oppressed free. Those who are in bondage have been set free. So there are two ways. Doing good of God and do good of man. There are two ways of doing good. When you do good of man, of God, it will definitely go to the root of that problem. If you do good of God, it gives refuge, it sets people free, straight. This is what makes us pastor. And you must be anointed by God to do good of him. If you are not anointed by God, you cannot do good of God. In the same way, you must also be anointed of man to do good of man. There's no way you can do good of God without being anointed by God. So, come in and begin to collect this, collect that, collect this, collect that. Out of 100 that will give, 50 of them are not from the heart. That will go a long way to neutralize the one that you, the other 50, to affect the other 50. Take note, there are two good, doing good of man, doing good of God. You must be anointed by God to do good of God. Because you need enablement to do good of him. You can be rich without God. Yes. But lack peace of heart. You can be in a position of whatever you call high position. The head, the president, the king, the queen, billionaire, whatever, without God. But without peace of heart. And whatever you are, without peace of heart, is zero. It's better not to have without peace of heart. When without peace of heart, when you live in the palace, it's like you live in the bush. And with the peace of heart, when you live in the bush, it's like you live in the palace. Are you with me? With peace of heart, when you live in the bush, it's like you live in the palace. Without peace of heart, when you live in the palace, it's like you live in what? The bush, without security. So peace of heart give contentment. Contentment lies. You see people, I'm okay. And you say, are you sure you are okay? You say, oh, okay. When you have peace of heart, you will not compare yourself to others. Whatever others have does will not bother you. You know, I am what God says I am. I have what God says I have. I can do what God says I can do. That is the peace of heart. You will not begin to compare yourself to others. Looking at the other, that Jeep. Look at mine. I want to go and buy that Jeep. Oh, look at that young man. I want to be like that young man. No. You will not make hearing yourself. You will begin to do good for God's sake. Not for selfish, not for classic, not for material reason. I'm giving you this because I know you will do this for me. No. No. Peace of heart. You know, everyone needs a contentment life. You need to be content. You need to be what? You need to be. This is the trouble we all have today. We are not content. We are not satisfied. No matter what you have, the bigger you have, the bigger you look for. We are not content. This is the trouble we have. All of us, we are not content. You ask for two, and you are saying, if you give me this two, I'm okay. After I receive two, you begin to look at those who have four. You want to have four. So that continues to stress, causing pressure and tension. Pressure and tension. Unnecessary pressure and what? Tension. You begin to have tension, pressure. That causes sickness, disease, hypertension, heart attack, running, helter, skelter, vanity upon vanity. Oh, it's vanity. Vanity. Hallelujah. So take note of that. There are good of God and good of man. So when you are blessed with good of God, you are blessed forever. Hallelujah. So please take your time. Yes. Sometime last year, I was just talking to myself. Each time I pray, I ask God. Smile. Happy. my unhappy? How can everybody, it's not possible for everyone to be happy. No, for those whom God sent me to. If God sent me to you, I should be able to locate you. I should be able to give you what... Not everyone, but some. When I was, that was when I was 50. I said, I keep praying. I said, this, I would have loved this birth, my birthday of 51 to offer this gift. I said, God, God. You know, we men of God, sometimes we challenge, we crying to God just like you cry to your father. We want something done. We want something done. We want something done. That is when the revelation of this new anointing water come. And faith bracelets. Let them show you. Please play it. Let us just see the picture of what I'm talking about. Brother. Push this thing, it's covering the people's face. Yes. I say, if that is the case, to change life, money is insufficient. Money is insufficient. There is no amount of money you can use to change one's life. You can only change one's life, do good of man, not of God. If you give $3 million, look at, let's watch. This is bad. Imagine for something to be packed like this. Don't forget about the anointing water. The length we go to pack it. If that what is a water, there is no need of packing it because water is everywhere. If it is water, there is no need of limit the quantity, just the little you have in the bottle because you have water everywhere. But this, because God call it heavenly currency. If it is heavenly currency, okay, we need passport then. Faith is a passport, but the pack to put your passport. God say, I will give you the grace to prepare that. When you have it, you have your faith. So we have to go on then to build this, the picture of what I have seen in the vision, bring it to reality and try it and take many countries who can build this thing, who can do this job for us. We have to go all over to get it done under 6 months. When I was wearing it, people were saying, what is this? People want to wear it. I say, well, if you force me to give you, okay, no problem, I will give you. Mr. Tim Jones, I want to give you. But the funny thing is that we don't know the difference between Prophet TV Joshua and Mr. TV Joshua. Now it's out. Now. The question now is, the one some of our brothers, sisters, and people have received, okay, it's all right. When you see something, your pastor where you want it, he can give you. But the question is it T.B. Joshua or Prophet T.B. Joshua gave it? But this now with the passport, without that passport in it, now I'll be giving you. If you have received it by collecting it from me, I will retreat it back. I will now give you, Prophet Tim Joshua will now give you the one. Now, education now. You need to be educated on the use of it, so that you will not take it as a religious, material. We are not a religious people. We are Christian. There's a difference between religious and Christianity. We Christians believe that Jesus came to restore the relationship and fellowship between God and man. He came, which is quite different from religious. We are not religious. So, but you may see it in the hands, that kind. Religious people have it, but it's different. This will help you to confess whom you are in Christ Jesus at all time. To confess whom you are in Christ Jesus. And to reset the state of your heart. Because your belief and your connection and your relationship with God has to do with the state of your mind. It has to do with the state of what? The state of your mind at all times. Your mind is talking. You may not talk, but your faith is talking all the time. There is no minute your faith does not talk. Faith in who? Faith in who? In God, in this, in human being, in this, in that, in yourself. Take note. You may not talk, but your faith is busy all the time talking. As I'm talking now, your faith is talking. And what your faith is saying? Some faith are saying, how will I get it? Some faith are saying, I cannot get it. Some faith are saying, oh, no. Some faith are saying, it's not it. Blah, 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 blah. All kind of thing going on in your heart. All kind of talk. All kind of thinking. You don't have power. You go this way, your faith go this way. So, to reset your belief. You know, in our mouth there's power, but the belief in our heart is released by faith out of our mouth. It will help you to reset your belief. Look at, sometimes when we are in the church, see you sitting down. I say, you are not supposed to sit down like this. You are supposed to keep busy. As you are looking at me, you can begin to tell God, who is this man? Who is this young man that is talking to me? I need to know this man. God, I need revelation right now. My God, I want to know this man. Well, look at him. He's like my junior brother at home. This man look like my brother at home, look like my driver, look like my servant, look at my like my gardener at home. Who is he? Who is this man that is talking? Oh Lord, reveal to me. That is the prayer that should be going in your heart. But instead, you are looking at me. That is the use. While you are sitting down, keep busy. If your heart is disturbed, you can say, please God, reset my belief. I want to be stable. All doubt, all fear, all unbelief, flush it out, Lord. I want to be right. Renew my strength. You can begin to sing in your heart. While you are looking at me, you begin singing a beautiful song in your heart. And when you are going inside the vehicle, inside aircraft, you are supposed to be busy. Sometimes you say, oh, my altar, I'm very busy. I cannot go to the altar. I cannot go in there to leaning down and pray. I'm very busy. You just lie down on the bed. You are very tired. I'm busy with your message till you finally sleep off. By the time you sleep, you look around. Where is my faith bracelet? It's on the floor. You pick it. Before you move out of your bed, you start again, right while you are lying down. At orphanage, you cannot move. It could be anywhere. I realize that Satan catch people unprepared, because he know you want to go to the altar and pray. He know you have time to fast. A break in faith is breaking God. You only have break. You have break. When you are not here, you are in the business partner, you with your business partner, you are negotiating, you forget you are a Christian. The way you talk, you negotiate, you begin to talk, you need money. When they say, no, a breaking faith is breaking God. And Satan knows when you have break. That is when he will strike. He will not strike when you are with him. But he know, he will monitor you when you break, he'll get you. So you'll get to a level that by the time you begin to build your spiritual life, getting there, you will not even need this again. While you are sitting down without, your heart is talking, it's canting, it's praying. But today you believe in until you close your eye before you pray. But when you close your eye praying and you hear the church, a gunshot, you open your eyes. This is about that. To help you reset your world, your belief. We have not talked about anointing water. Okay, let's wash the faith bracelets. We have little for the little baby. For our class.
Nous sommes en train de regarder sur l'écran le nouveau bracelet WAN qui est maintenant disponible dans la pochette dans laquelle à l'intérieur se trouve le bracelet WAN. C'est votre comme un passeport. Vous voyez le bracelet qui sera à l'intérieur dans quelques instants qui va s'ouvrir. Montrer comment cela est en paquet.
Listen to that. Take it back a bit and zoom it. Is it to help you meditate day and night? And keep the way you read. You know, you read your Bible, there you leave everything. But no, it will help you to keep the word of God you have read. Okay, let's watch. This helps you meditate day and night. Keep God's word you read. Keep just where you read. Because the way we read is not here. It's here. It's in our memory. There's something here. There's something different. But we read just like we read history book. Nowhere. But the word of God should be here in our heart. Why books, other book we are reading should be here. Okay? Let's go ahead.
Just bring your attention that is the faith bracelet there with its cover. It comes in different shapes.
Resets your belief in Jesus Christ. Reset your belief. Our belief. Okay, wash their opponents. Their opponents, wash. You can express your faith in your fashion. You understand? That's why we have all class, category, gold, all kind of you can talk of. There's gold, silver, metal, So you can now express your faith in your work, in your fashion. When you put on the gold wears, you put on also gold faith bracelets. We have men's own, young ladies, women. So, like you, I have said, educational, to educate you, because many of you are used to, and all activity that is going on Emmanuel TV, we associate it with you. When we pray for you. That's why we put Emmanuel TV there. And whatever going on there, deliverance, given prayer, deliverance is associated with you. That is what is written there. That's why we put Emmanuel TV. So now, okay, the attorney back of, look at the back of it. So you receive it just with the pack like that. For you to know how important it is. We can't put this thing on a rubber band, No. But we ask God. This will soon take over your gold and your medal you hang in everywhere. Because it's going to, So thank you. We have it for you. And I, like I have said, every problem is to transform you. You need peace of heart. Peace of heart will begin to show you or tell you the end of your day. The end. Your beginning and also show you the end. And this peace of heart is inheritance. When you have it, it will be possible for you also to transfer this by the grace of God to your people, your people around you. You need peace of heart. You'll be able to manage your business, your home, your family. You'll be able to manage them, peace of heart. When you have peace of heart, you will know God is with you. You will know. You will know God is with you. God never stops talking to our hearts. Our heart is the communication point. Our heart. Not here. We don't hear God through here. Here, when you talk to him, I will hear you through here. If anybody is saying God, it's not God that is talking to him, evil spirit. We don't hear God here, our heart. And he never stops talking to us. You may not hear because of hindrance. You may not hear him because of hindrance and barrier. But there's voice going on. But because there's conflict in your heart. Negative and positive. And negative is so much. The voice of evil spirit and you hear your voice also. So this will enable you and give you the grace to flush out all these fleshly thoughts. Fleshly thoughts. Fleshly thoughts. You keep busy. You stop crying. You continue to be busy. Let's let her. Imagine you want to sleep. You know, I used to say, tell you that when you are lying on your bed to sleep, you are going on journey. We have to take a very, very, take note of this. You just think that you want to sleep, you sleep. No! When you are about to sleep and you know that you have urge and you are about to sleep, you have to get ready. It's a journey. Now, if I have urge to sleep, I'm very tired and I'm about to sleep, I will not just rush to the bed. I will say, I'm going. Where am I going? Journey. Okay. I need to reconcile my account. I need to reconcile everything. Yes. What is it? What is the thought in my heart? What has happened to me now? I should not sleep with that kind of... I should not go to bed with that kind of thought. I should not go to bed with disturbed, doubting, worry. I should not go to bed with that. I should be able to reset my baby immediately sitting down and laugh and connect proper. You don't need to go because you are very tired or you begin to look for water. I need to be on my knee. No, no, no. Just sit down anywhere on your bed. Connect proper and begin to sing and praise him and thank him. Or thank him and praise him and thank him, thank him. You need revelation. There are many things you need to know. I mean, God's opinion about yourself, God's opinion about this person, God's opinion about your nation. God reveals to me revelation. God, please, singing choruses, wonderful songs. And then, while you are doing that, sleep me. You just find yourself, you are gone. Your faith bracelet may be somewhere. You know, when you are sleeping, it will just drop somewhere. Then, I want to promise you, by the time you wake up, you have a revelation. Because the journey starts wonderful. The reason of nightmare, God is merciful God. The reason of nightmare, attack in the dream, because the way you go to your bed, you are not prepared the journey. You are not disconnect yourself before you sleep. You are not disconnect yourself before you walk. You have to separate yourself from all this before you finally sleep. So this is blessing for you, and faith bracelet will help you, will go a long way to help you. So and like I've said, there's a pamphlet. You need to read about it, the use, how to use it. I'm writing a short note in short book about this faith bracelet. What it is? Is it different from religious explanation? Is there? How can you grow? How can you build your relationship with God? And what is it going to do for you? How do we use it? So all this is just 5 pages. The small booklet. There is a space in that passport that we are going to put it. Please play the bar. Bring it. Bring one. Let me show you. There's a space where what we prepare for the book. It will go along with the book.
El profeta que vivió ya a mostrar que los había identificado con el FNI, su paquete, el pasaporte de la mesa celestial.
So the book will be here. So there will be a little pamphlet that will go in. That as you receive it, you open the pamphlet, you read. The use of faith. Drop it. Yes. So it will go in. So a pamphlet is prepared to go in to explain the use. How important. Is it really scriptural? What it is? How come? What kind of revelation? What revelation do I receive before having this? So everything is explained in that book. And I know. Let me first of all thank you very much for your prayer, because I know you are praying for me, and more especially partner all over the world. I feel your prayer, and I know. Each time I move, the Lord said to me, millions are praying for you. Millions. Not only that, God will say, millions are praying for you. Ah, millions are disturbing me concerning you. I said, oh my God, disturbing God. He said, yes. They keep asking for mercy, more favor. Thank you, Lord. God keep telling me, millions all over the world. There are some people that when they wake up, that is the job they do. They don't even bother to pray for themselves. They say, this man praying for me. God revealed this revelation to me. And say, these are partners. They support spiritually. Always. And I want to thank you. And if I just stand here and say thank you, it's words of thank you. It must be indeed. So this is outcome. So now, as I'm talking now, because of you, we have a very huge contract with Korea Services. So there are many companies like DHL and many others, those whom we have done our finding, they have a good reputable, and we have signed agreement with them. So any country we look, we first of all have to dispatch the one for the partners, which will start immediately. You will just find it in your door mouth. Someone will just knock on the door and say, this is from the Senegal church. By the time you open it, you'll see. And this new anointing water for each partner, three. You, your husband, your wife, and one for your family in general. Take note. You may be wife or husband, but one for you, one for your husband or your wife, and another one for your children, your families and friends. Make it three. Plus faith bracelets, one. So these are the things we package, we want to courier to the partners. If we have 100 or 1 million in any country, we look at the partner on the list and count how many of them, there are 100 million. They have to ship it to that country. And from there they can begin to call the houses, the person concerned, and they can now go to the town and distribute and give it to them. So this is arrangement we have made. Former anointing water was not like that, because we know how important it is. And we really want to tell you that we love you so much. You know, we have not called any conferences or meetings for some year now. I say, oh, call conferences. Say, conferences. Conferences that will turn to healing and deliverance. If you call conferences of partner now, before you know it, will turn to deliverance and healing. You see, people begin to say, I'm a son, I'm a kutak. Or someone, a partner that will come and say, I have so much pain. Can I talk to such a partner? I will not be able to talk. So, such conferences would not have meaning. So I say, God, deliver these people out. Let them come in a month. By the time you receive it, we count a month. After a month, we now invite the partners. Because I know you have a huge testimony. By then, I'll be talking to ex-sick people, ex failure. Ash. Oh, you know what I'm talking about, because this is just it. Yes, I'll be talking to S failure. I will not be talking to failure, rather S failure. To sit down, talking to them, people can now begin to share their testimony. Yes, I received this anointing water. Immediately, the sickness I have disappeared, and my dream now, I understand what I'm doing. Things are going well. Oh, yes. These are the testimonies. Then we can have a short course. That is a program in your area of interest. As I know, you want me to deliver a lecture, talking to you as a partner? Yes. Emmanuel TV, I know you watch Emmanuel TV, but you still want to see me one-on-one, having a word with you. But this anointing water and the faith bracelet must get to your door mouth first. It must reach you for 1 month. You must exercise it, and for 1 month, then I know for that 1 month I can invite you for conference. Then we talk of conference. Hallelujah. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Yes, I'm talking of partner. Why others? I mean, it's for everyone. But I just want to say that special message to the partner all over the world. Because I told you what God is telling me, that you have people. I say, thank you, Lord. They are praying for you. I say, thank you, Lord. This is the voice of God. It's not you, partner, that messaging this. It is the voice of God to me. That's happened when I was 50 years. Then this message will continue disturbing me. People are praying for you. You have millions of people out there. They are your partner. I say, oh. So I think this girl, God said, this is my birthday gift. My birthday gift. At least at 51, I should have some great relief. Because the way people throw people, I know if anointing water get to your community, thousand people would not come here for healing, they will come for testimony. So that's it. So we are busy praying to God for how to deliver it. Because when it seems something like this, everybody want to have it. Everyone want to have it. So how do we give it? You remember the last year what happened, if not the grace of God. So therefore, how to give it? Since God has given all these many companies, Korea company, that have registered to us, they are ready, the job, they are ready to go straight, even taking millions to any countries. So watch us again, and to reach you at your home. That will give a great relief. And all others that will come here to collect, we can meet them. And give them. So once again, I want to say thank you. Thank you very much.
Muchas gracias por su oración y nuestro apostolado celestial y la audiencia.
Yes, that was yesterday. This is it, the new one. I don't know whether you had the video yesterday, the first woman that ministered this. If you have it, play it. The first woman that was minister, it was a, many people were here yesterday. And it just, this is anti-affliction. You know, let me give you, for the past 3 days, I was just moving, something caught my hand. I want to throw something, and the thing caught, and my hand started bleeding. Serious, profound one, and the blood was gushing out. And I have this in my pocket. I remove it and I spread it. Could you believe that the blood I was seeing turned to water? Today you will have seen me putting a plaster on my hand. You will say what happened to Pastor. But it just changed, just like that. How many of you were in the service yesterday? You saw that woman.
Yes.
I would have wanted them to just show. The woman is was moving around. That saw and the bone immediately yesterday became normal. And now the face of the saw is drying. No, this thing is so much that when you have it and you have someone who has a big saw, you just spread it on the cutting wool. Just little. Spread it on the cutting wool and put that cutting wool in the face of the saw. So you just spread it on the cutting wool and wet the cutting wool with the water and place it on the cutting wool. Then by next first day, second day, it will become flesh by. The cutting wool will become flesh. Ah, I will want them to show you some of the cases in the past that we put cutting wool in the cancer and becoming one. Now, if you now have a pain inside your stomach, maybe wound, and you take it, no one will tell you that you are free, because it dent just like it dent my hand. Your hand will become immediately dead for a moment. Later, you can now recover yourself. Then you know something is working. It's not something you minister, you will not know that it's working. It is something when you touch your body, you will know something is wrong. Now coming to hardship, which is the deadly disease. I consider what you call HIV, I don't know what you call HIV. As for me, I know hardship is the deadly disease. Poverty. Because it's the cause of all this sickness. People that are sick today, 70% of sick people talk of HIV, talk of any cancer, as a result of poverty, those sickness come to their life. Poor people is not mind the kind of blood he will receive. Whether the blood is HIV infection, it's not mind, he will take it. Because it's lie. Poor one will not mind. I mean, nothing. You know, when you are poor, you lack of sense of just judgment. Sense of what? Sense of judgment. You can't reason well. Can't listen well. So hardship is deadly. This is anti-poverty. It's just a spray. When you have it, don't use your perfume again. Submit your perfume. If you like the perfume so much, you can spread it inside it. Just spread it. That's all. And so that's it. So I want, like I have said, at 51. You know, I've been in the job for the past 20 something years. Could imagine. And so far, I want to believe that there's no way you can attest. I mean, it's difficult for me to begin to talk to you when you are not happy. That is why it's so difficult for me to stand here and begin to say, your this, your contribution. We want to build this. We want to buy that. No. This is for you. Thank you. Yes, maybe before, maybe today what we needed, okay, watch this woman. Watch this woman. The woman that was given yesterday. Take it from beginning. You see? Take it from beginning. Who's on the table?
Según la pantalla, vamos a ver el video. En línea de oración, por primera vez el uso de la agua de unción nueva, vamos a ver la pantalla.
Watch.
Your minister,
Just at the distance. No, at the distance. No, come.
No,
come. Sorry. Oh, come. This is the left.
Okay, demander à cette femme d'utiliser la nouvelle dimension qui va bientôt sortir de ce
domaine. Sira. Sira.
Sira.
I will put it wrong. Touch it. This is the land. This is the land. What you say about it is energy. We call it energy. There is no enough energy in the land. The land lost energy. But what God is pumping, you see it so, but the energy were able to walk back. I mean, the faces of the sun. You see, you see that? This is the smoke bomb. Come on, it's smoke bomb. The energy is so much. The energy is so much. You see, camera in the hand, far, distant. Who is the cameraman there? Face back. Now, can you see? Now you can see the woman is calm. She came with one person, someone had the left hand, and she used walking stick too. But right now the energy, she will be able to walk on now. The question and the mystery now, how many is able to match ground with this? Okay, let's play, let's watch.
See, it's all right. When the work is done, you see the body come down. Give me back. So you can stand up.
So, this is how it is to poverty. You never knew, you never knew that poverty is the major sickness you have. Because your doctor could not diagnose you. And I pray God will send, will anoint many doctors that will be able to diagnose poverty in your body. So because all the medical reports we are seeing, I've never seen medical report someone brought from the doctor and say, sir, doctor say I have poverty 1, 2, 3. It's poverty. When you are poor, even the environment you live, oh my God, you sleep inside mosquito. And this is mosquito that have gone far to take the blood of HIV people. Gone far to take and will come and deposit in your body and go back again and go and do another job.
Sure.
So you have seen. This is where we are. So now the question now today. I think we need to see more enough what this thing worth. And if God give us the grace, I have 50 of it, so that they will minister it to you. When it touches you, how you will feel, what will happen to you. So they will take it around, just minister. Even if I spread it to the air here, it will affect, you know this, there's some chemical, when they drop it on the air, you start sleeping. If chemical can do so much, that if they just drop chemical on the air, everybody here will sleep off. So this one will do. It will, whatever amen in your body, and it sense what is not possible for medical doctor to sense, he senses. So you saw the leg, the woman's leg was shaking like this, and suddenly he placed it down, and this is the leg, it was moving like this before, he could not mash it on the ground. Okay, how come about the bone, the flesh, how come about it? So this is, and I will make sure I will do every proper thing to maintain the grace of this, because sometimes the manner we give it affect the grace of God. The grace is so high and so mighty now, but when corruption comes into it, it affects the Spirit of God, begin to diminish. Corruption, misplacement, the manner we give it now will allow this. Are you with me? That to show that it is no matter of money now. Money is insufficient. It's no issue of money now. To maintain the grace here, it is no issue of money. Money can't out of it. So now how do we give it? So like I have recommended, I will personally try to give the 50 so that let them minister it. And the faith bracelet, like I have said, the booklet of it, which will be sent along with it to the partner all over the world. And start also giving it to you according to the way you know what it is. You must have revelation about this thing. It's not issue of fighting for it, no, issue of faith. So thank you very much. Hallelujah. What next? God has settled our matter. I say our matter is settled. It's just settled. You know, it's just settled. The matter is settled. It is not issue of, even when you see the package of it, you will know that it's something of interest. Package of it, give me the other one. Package of faith, it's not possible for me to just put a mere gold, a mere whatever you call it. Ramp it for what? Because if God opens your eyes spiritually, you will know what I put here. Why I protect it this way? It is something more than gold. This miracle, this is a lifetime with Christ to develop your relationship. Thereby, you can sit down and dream, and know God's opinion about yourself and about others. So you'll be able to maintain your miracle, because our relationship with God gave us grace to maintain our miracle. One thing to receive, another thing is to maintain it. We have so much challenges today in this world. The challenge is so big. Where can we start from? World in East, world in South, world in West, world in everywhere, war. Each country has its own war, different kind of wars, different style, kinds of war. Each country are fighting. And innocent people are being killed every day. Innocent. So what are we talking about? You need your heart to talk to you. You need to hear God's voice in your heart, not here. If you hear something here, it will be disturbed. The noise outside there can disturb anything you hear here. You say, I can't hear you well. I can't hear you well. What are you saying? I can't hear, okay. The line is not clear. Call me back. That is here. If that message is from here, it's a sacred place. Only God divine can. There's no disturbed, no distort here. This is where God talked to us. So, are you here? Have this and have this. Have this and have this. You can't give you something without house. You must have house for it. Whatever they give you by hand and the thing has no house, you know that it's from the street. But house. So, please, I don't know how to, I don't want to talk much. I will leave the grace to talk by itself. Yes, we have some emergency there I want to attend to. And a lot of people were attended to yesterday. We have almost 20 prayer line. Imagine attending to prayer line, 20 of numbers. Each line contain almost 200. So all were attended to yesterday. And there are testimonies that are waiting. I think mother of testimony is about to happen. I want them to hold on. So, and yes, I will be coming back to join you for the grace of prophetic and the anointing water we want to exercise. But let me move there and attend to the sick one. So I will come back. Don't forget that the wise men too are coming to lay hand on you. So imagine you are passing through many screening. I said through many screening. What a God we serve. Thank you, God. Thank you. So, viewers all over the world, I want to move to the prayer line. So, after leaving the prayer line, I know I have many jobs to do here among you. So, I will come back, pray with you. There's a grace to deliver message. I'll do so. Anointing water as well. The faith bracelet, like I've said, is ready, it's in time. But the question on how to give it, and like I have said, I want especially recognize to thank those who are praying, are there praying for me. Some email, if I bring some email here, the letter I receive, you will be very surprised. Some people, I will invite them personally that, come, what are you saying? He said, the Lord said, whatever he's doing, he should just leave it. He has enough. And just continue praying for this man. Praying for this man will secure is in him. I said, wow. God said to you, if God could do so much and have and plant people all over the world to be praying for me, I think so I should also think about their protection. Protection of their family and their own protection. And their protection after they might have left, they might have bowed to this world. Their name also will remain. You know, the grace of God is beyond the grave. So I'm thinking about that. That brought about this. And I can't wait. It's the way I'm going about it, as if I should begin to give it. But I'm waiting for God's instruction. Because I want to hear your testimony. Mainly on those unyielding issue. You have been praying over certain issue for so long, and those things refuse to yield to prayer. This are the uncommon situation, uncommon challenges you have been having. Not just challenging, uncommon one. These are the main reason God has given us this. So, like I've said, I'm going to prayer line. So after prayer line, I will come back. So thank you. Thank you. God bless. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you.
Bendito el mundo, el profeta ha dicho, la sección de la línea de oración, y de pronto volverá a la línea y orar masiva.
Prayer line, I'm coming back. Okay?
Donc, le nom de Dieu parlait du nouvel eau d'onction qui est maintenant de sortie, et aussi le nouveau bracelet Rouen qui est aussi disponible très bientôt. En vue de l'emballage de ce bracelet Rouen, nous avons déjà dit que c'est quelque chose de très précieux, c'est pour cela que c'est un emballage spécial. Et maintenant, nous allons passer à la ligne de prière, la section de la ligne de prière. Restez connectés avec nos téléspectateurs.
Le nom de Dieu a dit que c'est la section de la ligne d'oration et posteriormente.
Come forward, let's talk. You may be seated just for a moment. Thank you. Evangelist, wherever you are under the canopy, please come forward here. Evangelist, thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, viewers. Thank you for your patience.
Televidente, gracias por su paciencia.
Hallelujah. And those who are under the canopy there, and I know the evangelists are walking towards you. Please bear with me. Every big thing starts little. If something big starts big, started big, it calls for concern. If something big started big, it calls for concern. In the same way, if your faith must be very steadfast, strong, it must start with little faith. Hallelujah. Yes, I saw what was going on, but you have not seen anything because I just picked the one on top, where it's in a very where God for the past 6 months it has been there. I just picked the one that dropped on the floor, which is almost 60, which millions are there. So it will manifest mightily when you minister to yourself, not someone minister to you. Take note of that. It's part of the prayer I offer. I ask God, the grace I ask God. It will manifest greatly, mightily, when you yourself, as in Jesus, now manifest it yourself. It will manifest greater than someone, than TB Joshua himself, than TB Joshua minister to you. Because it's connected with you. The job, our job is to hand over to you. Once we give you, and it manifests greatly where there is greater challenges, health greater challenges like cancer, HIV, hypertension, kidney problem. You say someone is in coma and you take it there, it must, if that is, even the person will still die. You hear, pum, 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 and everybody will shout, ah, is that not the person that is in coma for many months? Take note. If someone is in coma and he has not given up, but it is destined that he or she will die, but he has not given up, something must happen to really show that the presence of God is there. When you minister here, you hear, from there he may give up. If it is destined that the hour has come. Once again, this anointing water manifests greatly more where there is greater health challenges. Not this, the one we have been ministered. I know some people have some terminal disease inside them, but not on the outside. You may have terminal disease in your body. If they just give you the little you put in your mouth, unless you don't have saliva. Do you have anyone that does not have saliva? Unless you don't, you do not have saliva. If you have saliva and they spray it in your mouth, you'll be doing like this. You feel something, there's a taste in your mouth, but you don't know what that taste is all about. It's going down. It's head disease. It's anti-disease. You see what's happened? Under just 2 hours, under just one and a half hours, the anointing water have finished inside the church, they are outside there. It means under 2 hours they can attend to the whole church. And you see them vomiting. The fibroid is being caught inside the stomach. Those who have fibroid, once you are able to swallow, because there are some people, they don't have grace to swallow it because they were rushing. They just spread it on you, not that you do it yourself. If you have fibroid, if you open your mouth and spread it, it will cut those fibroids into pieces. Now, going to toilet, you can begin to deliver them gradually. Because it will be very dangerous for you to just deliver a big fibroid like this. But it will cut it into pieces and grind it. You just find yourself bleeding. Talk of poverty, hardship. That is the major reason why this anointing water is out. Because it is a crime for anyone not to see food on the table. It's a crime. What you should bother about? Surplus. Not what you need. So the situation, the challenge in the world today, because we are in the war, without faith, without hope. So once again, it manifests greatly when you minister it yourself, not someone else ministers to you. If I minister it to you, it will not manifest greatly up to it. When you minister it to yourself. So because that is the principle there. It's yours. Because what you said is what will happen. Heal me, deliver me, rebuild my castle. Whatever you mention while you minister, it work according to your confession. And it regulates confession. So I want to assure you once again, it's yours. Just be patient. Be patient. It is yours. So it is yours. So we just pick some. It's like you put water inside the cup and you overflow. And you started drinking the one that dropped on the floor. Will you enjoy the one drop on the floor than the one inside the cup? Because the one drop on the floor is contaminated with the sand and all of that. So that is exactly what you are about to receive. So God loves you. Thank you very much. Because of the fear of this blessing, so that it will not become a crime, I will not stand on the last day and begin to answer query. The Lord said to me, this must go with faith bracelets. Because the purpose of your blessing is for salvation of your soul. The purpose of your blessing is to keep your relationship with God. That is the purpose. And this will help you. So it go with this, because I'm afraid so much you receive and you cannot give so much love to God. I mean, we answer query. So this is why it go immediately. We were waiting for this. Anointing water was ready last month, and we are still keeping it, but we were waiting for this. Go with it to build your faith. To reset your belief. Yes. And not only that, those of you that have that spray, something, they spray something before you, even though you could not taste it, because it scattered on the air, but you feel it, they face you, they spray it in your body. Today, you must have a revelation in your dream. You must have a dream. Yes. You'll be going, living here, you want to sleep, you'll see the kind of dream you have. You'll just sleep, you dream, that you dream, you don't understand your dream, you don't used to dream, that is not normal. That you just, they just spread it whether you tested it or not. You must have some dream to tell, which is very important. So thank you. Hallelujah. I want to thank you once again for your prayer and your support. And your prophet will be 1 year older on this coming Thursday. Once again, your prophet will be 1 year older. 1 year older. This coming Thursday, I want to thank you for your prayer and your support. And yes, I want to thank you, because I told you in the morning that oftentimes God keep telling me that your people love you so much. They pray for you, they disturb me. This is the voice in my heart. They disturb me. Who are these people asking for mercy, for more grace for you? I said, wow. I know you are, and the viewers all over the world. Once again, thank you very much for your prayer. And thank you for your prayer. Thank you for your prayer. So we have people all over the world that they actually devote their time to pray for their pastor, prophet, and you know your prophet needs your prayer. And yes. And I would not stand here and begin to say thank you, thank you, thank you without express. This is one of the expression, the anointing water you are seeing, and the faith bracelets. Now you can now begin to look at the kind of man you are about to celebrate. The kind of man you are about to celebrate. The man that show interest in your life changing, life transformation. The man that want to see you, elevate. See yourself the way God created you. Because many life have changed. And the man want to see life changing, transformation. Just, this is the kind of, I want to see the sick being healed. Oppression be delivered. I want to see freedom. I want to see you smile. I want to see food on your table, money in your pocket. Yes. If there's anything to you are bothering about, maybe surplus. You need abundant, but immediate one you need must be ready. Should not so issue to think about. Giving you sleepless night. Can be able to take care of your people, take care of your responsibility. I know what man wants is unlimited. But today, opposite is the case. So I ask God, Lord, if you want me to remain in the midst of your people, because I can't stay in your midst and be, look at you. Every day you see people trooping, and they keep duping them. There's foster everywhere. If I show you many anointing water people have done, sending, you'll be very surprised to see a lot of things. A woman is here that was crying. They have duped many people. There was a country they organized crusade. Someone says TB Joshua, and they keep organizing this crusade, and they have hired a stadium. They have paid a lot of money, $200,000, and they have hired it. Everything. It was fine. They were saying when the arrival, and we receive that email here, and we cry out. We don't know anything about this organization. This crusade. Already, almost $200,000 have gone. People use those opportunity of people challenges, people solution, people want rest, people want peace. So people are using this. So I think enough is enough. By the grace of God. And I want to assure you and I also warn you, don't let anybody deceive you that we send the anointing water, send money, there's nothing like that. Even anyone is telling you send money, send anointing water, you know it's not from this place. So we cannot use anointing water exchange it for money. When you hear bring money, we send you book, we send you anointing water, you know it's foster. Never you listen to people like that. So because we don't know how to go about it in the past anointing water, the former anointing water, we have to give you mirror, giving you anointing water. Because we just want to regulate the number of people coming to get it. If not, but this one, since we have faith bracelets, I think with the arrangement we have made with Korea, I think it will be easier. Because this is issue of, we have been in this arrangement for long, and I know it will work out. So it will be more fair than the former. So don't let anyone deceive you, because you need anointing water. There's nothing. Money, anointing water, there's nothing like that. I told you, when money is involved, it affects the grace. Okay? It affects the grace. God knows what you can do. We know what you can do. When you have peace and comfort, you'll do better than when you have trouble. Are you with me? When you run to a person for, you have trouble, you run to a pastor. I have trouble. I have sickness. Whatever you give to that pastor, you give it out of sickness. out of disease. But we ministers of God, we don't know the, it's a crime, and it destroys the career of the ministry and the person in charge. When you run to me, man of God, I have this, I have cancer, I have disease, and you are a millionaire, you have money. I have disease, I have cancer, I'm buried, I need child, this. And you give money in that process, you are giving out of your problem to the pastor. So we should not collect anything at that situation, at that. But when everything is over, when you now give something, when everything is over, you give it out of peace and comfort. Compared to when you give out of sickness, disease. So this is why today you see all over the world, our many of our end, we great men, our end, many of us, our end are not good at all. We may flow well, but at the end, it's only story. And the empire we build and everything we build seems to collapse because we take from people when they are in trouble. Out of trouble we collect it, out of the pain they give us, and whatever we ask them they give because they need solution. They are desperate. Look at this anointing water. If I say one is $5,000, you are ready, but I will receive 1 million trouble. You give me $5,000, but I'll receive 1 million trouble. I don't want that. So, this is just the challenge in the world today. Out of 10 gifts we receive, 9 out of 8 we receive it when people are in pain, they give us because they need solution. When people are in trouble, they give us, we ask them to bring something, they give us. So when they are giving us this, out of when they are in trouble, confusion, it's different when people give you something when freedom comes. I say, oh, thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Oh, my God. Thank you, sir. Oh, no, I'm one of this. Oh, I'm short of words. I'm happy. I'm happy, sir. I'm happy, sir. Out of joy, he's giving you joy. Out of peace, he's giving you peace. So, can you see? And I want to advise you that you too, you should not be a temptation. You should also help ministers all over the world. When you have contact with them, try to see what you can do to help on your own side. So you can be a right hand for the ministers. Because ministers of God too, they need right hand people. So there are many assistants, people that right-hand assistant, left-hand assistant. Never you be a left-hand assistant, be a right-hand assistant. Are you with me? You know what you can use your right hand for, you cannot use your left hand for. Because no one can succeed alone. Like what I'm saying now, like this anointing water, your duty now is to be vigilant. If you see anything going on about this name, anointing water, we should protect the name. Protect that name of God in that water. There is water and there is the name of God in the water. That make it anointing water. So don't look at it and say, I need my own. Not only you need your own, you should make sure you protect the name of God inside that water. When you go out, you hear anything, you mean they are selling it, somebody is doing it, you should rise up and go there, see what you can do. And report it to the church, see what they can do, so that they will stop duping people. And you too should not be accessible for comment, because some of us, out of desperate, you are ready. You are ready?
No. I mean,
so because as we are talking now, some wicked people, they are making some arrangement now to get their own in the same way to do, and do people. For now, you can't find it anywhere. Until maybe when we meet next, or if we send anointing water to you, we inform you beforehand and we make sure we speak to you on the phone, your coordinator, and we get in touch to you. We make sure you have that arrangement will be there. So don't let anybody dupe you. It's not available anywhere for now. So you can't find it anywhere. That is why it is what it is. It's not something you can find on the street. It's rare, precious, dear. So yes, that is it. Hallelujah. Yes, hallelujah. So it's dear, it's not something common. That is why you see it manifest, you see manifestation like that. It's not something you can get in the bookshop or in the market. No, you can't find it. Look at the 1,000 people here. No one can claim to have it. It's just like that. Oh, everybody want money. If it is you have money, can you see a million people around? Everybody want it. You know, if really after money, you know how much millions of dollars today. We make millions of dollars, but we are not interested in that. The name of God. Money is insufficient. I have realized during my calling, I realized that the end is more important than anything. Whatever we are doing now, that's the end. It's more important than the beginning. It's more important than even the middle. The end. Whatever you can do to have that end and glorify God, I say, thank you, Jesus. I fight a good battle. I run the race. Do it. It is not money or gold that have been fighting for me. I have been facing rare situations that it's not possible to overcome, but God. Money cannot do that. In the midst of trillion people, only just one man, when he's talking, this is light there. Others say no, they cannot see light. At the end, it is light. So what else do I want from God? Huh? What else again? When I say this is light there, no one could see the light. So at the end, people say it's light. Just that voice. What else again do I want? What other victory? If your voice could be heard. What else again? That is not money. I cannot be richer than. It's not possible. It is the grace of God. Grace of God. So once again, your prophet will be 1 year older. So now come to the celebration. But you know, my children, they are still in the Sabisa there. You know the message from beginning. Some are in the bush, some will come back. You begin to see them, but I'm right now where the prophet is talking and people are not listening. You seems to be very, I mean, you don't know what to say again. And it's not possible for me, you just hear that prophet is in Borno to do what? But once again, those children, I want to assure the parent, they should sleep and wake up quietly and close their eyes. The children will come back. There's nothing happened to the children. There are many things around us that that even when you are laughing, you should laugh quietly. You should not laugh louder, because you too want to really sympathize with people around. So therefore, the wound of one is the wound of all. Thank you. You mean when one have wound, other should feel the wound. So I think we have some, our surrounding and environment are not comfortable enough. I think we should pray them all. Fast and pray for the prophet and the nation. That is the best way to celebrate my 51st birthday. So I, gathering, coming together and gathering together, unless you want to pray with me here, you are ready to come and fast and pray with me, you are welcome. But I will not be able to, well, because if I'm not a prophet, I think I should be front, I should be activist, carry placard and begin to campaign, bring back our what? Our girl. Yes, if I'm not a prophet, that is my job. If I'm not a prophet, I should be number one activist on the street, carry the placard, carry the poster, and campaign for the release. This is what I'm born for, I'm going to live for, and I'm going to die for. So, but I'm a prophet, I can't join you carry the placard or posters. On my own, I'm carrying it inside the church here. If you listen to my message, see, the context of my message, you know this man is an activist. Activist, apostle, is an activist as well. So, therefore, well, I'm telling God, if God will use that to celebrate my birthday, well, we are looking for, everything around, even our little one is released today, there's more other things. Because I was showing some revelation 3 days ago, and then we should pray for Abuja again. I'm seeing another bomb there. They should pray and pray security tight. And I say, God, this is I'm celebrating my birthday on Thursday. What is scare something? They should pray. 3 days ago, I saw. And I saw something like that, and it was, would have been very devastated like the other one. But we are praying that the Lord should please, mercy, mercy, mercy. We are waiting for our children to come back. Why all this rubbish? So we are praying. This will have happened last week here. We keep praying and pray to God that all this should not happen, because it will disturb me. As a person, I will be disturbed so much. I'll be disturbed. So these are the challenges we are facing, and I'm not out of this. I'm, as a prophet, I remember, I pray for your nation, not only Nigeria, all over the world. This is Church of All Nations. So once again, this birthday is not, it's just get together and fast and pray. You have to pray. You better do that in your home. Or if you choose to come to Lagos, come to synagogue, you'll join us fast and pray. And like I promise you, your anointing water and the faith bracelets. That is my birthday gift for you. You must receive it. Yes. Okay. But we should not use that day. It should not be that day. Okay? Because I would not want so much crowd here. The church activity should remain the way it has been. On Thursday, we don't have people around. I wonder whether if there's any few people inside the church, maybe they are praying and fast for the prophet and the nation and the whole world. So thank you. So thank you once again. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I realize many are not rich. We want to pray together. Yes, we call it lose your grave. Tell your neighbor, lose your grave. So that is Satan. So whatever area in your life that have challenges, which I know we have touched you, we are praying for you. But your people, your business, your finances, right now I command Satan to lose his grip. I say, you Satan, lose your grip. I said, lose your grip. I said, lose your grip. In the name of Jesus, lose your grip. Open your lips and begin to command Satan to lose his grip. I'm a child of God. I'm a child of God. Lose your grip. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Remember, Satan is behind your challenges. I say Satan is responsible for your situation. Yes. Listen to me. Satan and his people, they are behind your challenges. I mean, they are responsible for your situation. So this is why I say, lose your grip. You are a child of God. Let him know. I'm a child of God. You Satan. I say, I'm a child of God. In the name of Jesus, I command you, lose your grip. In the name of Jesus, prayer.
Impoderación, hijo de Dios, suéltame, nombre poderoso de Jesucristo.
Jesus Christ. Now you say, Satan, lose your grip. Now you can begin to release your business now. Release your finances. Release your health. Right now, begin to release your business, release your career. Begin to release your career.
Libérez vos affaires.
Libérez su carrera.
Thank you.
mighty name of Jesus Christ. So I want